Still, it's up to the director, isn't it?
It is.
I'm the
Who would you
producer.
want?
Who would I want to play me? Beyoncé.
There you
That'd be
go.
cruel. That'd be cruel. That'd be cool.
That would be cruel. Is
No.
that
No.
what you said at first?
That would probably be cruel for her though, because she'd be like, "Who is this girl? Wow. I'm sorry that
Next
you
one,
have to
next
put
one.
in hours to play this girl that you probably don't know. Most likely don't know. But she
It'll work
appreciates it
though. She will. She
a
will. All right.
lot."
So to question number two.
Okay.
What fictional character would be the most exciting to meet in real life?
Oh my God. Almost all the mangas that I read. Okay.
So that's your favorite? Reading mangas is your favorite.
Yeah. If I could meet all of them in real life, that'd be real cool.
Well, you know what? Hopefully one day we can find a way to make that happen, I guess. Well, some virtual reality thing. All right. Next one.
Okay.
What are your favorite venues to perform in?
I don't really have a favorite venue because I haven't really performed in all venues. So we'll just have to wait until I've performed in all venues all around the world for me to pick a favorite.
Okay,
And
next
keep
fan
your
question.
options wide open. Yes,
Indeed,
let's
indeed.
go.
How will you define a life well lived? P.S. I love you so much from Joanna
Thank
Maylin.
you, Joanna. I love you too. A life full of failures, that you turn into success, and a life that you feel that you accomplished your goal. Well, because failures, words are meaningless, right? It's the people that give meaning to them. And failure in my eyes, it's an opportunity to try something new and it just doesn't work out. But it doesn't have to end there.
Right.
Success is basically I forgot the saying, but most people in their lives, most successful people have failed, but what they did was they kept being as persistent as they were, oh, as they still are. And, after failures, after failures, they just kept going at it until it was a success. Not
Definitely,
saying that it
definitely.
was easy at all, but they just kept going at it.
Kept
Until
going
it's
at it.
like, hum, bam, success.
Perseverance, success, baby.
Perseverance. That's definitely what it is. So,
All
yeah.
right.
And that's
And
actually something I always ask my little brothers and little sisters. It's kind of a reverse psychology type of thing where I ask them, so what have you failed at today? And if they have, I know it sounds harsh, but when they have nothing to say, I'm always like, I always get very disappointed, purely for the fact that why, if they haven't failed at anything, it means that they haven't tried anything new.
Ooh, good point.
So, yeah, so it's like, of course, when a baby first tries to walk, of course they're gonna fall.
Right.
That counts as a failure. But
Indeed.
it's the fact that they persevered. And it's a no-brainer thing in their mind. They persevered and just kept trying to walk until they did, until it became something that's just as easy as, probably not as easy as getting up in the morning. But yeah, just walking is just like, it's a no-brainer thing anymore,
Yeah,
So that's
definitely.
what it is. So that's why I always say what I say. There's a reason for everything I do. Just keeping up
Excellent.
there.
Let's do another fan question. Let's see what's going on.
Let's go.
Yanni Princess, name three artists close to your heart. You did name a few earlier. Any more that you didn't mention?
I think Taylor Swift is definitely an artist that's close to my heart. Other than the fact that I think she's a great songwriter, most of the songs that she Oh, just other than the fact that I think she's a really great artist, the way she songwrites a lot of things is, you know, is even before I, you know, just discovered Taylor as an artist, that she was an artist. It's kind of similar to a lot of the things that I'd like to read. So the songs that I hear her sing, it's really nice. Yeah.
Okay.
So she's very close to my heart in that sense with how she songwrites a lot of things. It's very relatable, and it's something that I just really keep close to my heart. I don't know how else I can say it.
Yeah. Great answer though.
Who else? Michael Jackson. It's a no-brainer thing, you know.
Yeah. No questions asked. I totally understand that one for sure.
Right. And last one is probably, I think Harry Styles.
Oh, wow.
I love the way he writes and sings a lot of things. I think he has great artistry.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, I just think he's an overall great artist. And I think they're all great people too.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know them, but they seem like great people.
Definitely. All right, couple more. Let's go. Next one. From Mellow.
Hey, Mellow.
If you could spend the one whole day with a famous person, who would you spend the day with? Where would you go? Mellow.
I'd spend the day with... thanks for the question, Mellow. Because he actually got me thinking about this. Daydreaming about something like this. That'd be really cool. I'd really like to spend the day with Selena Gomez. I think she's real cool.
She is.
She's also someone I keep close to my heart too. But yeah, I'd like to spend a day with her, and I'd like to travel to Japan with her. Yeah.
Nice. Very specific with that. I like that answer. Excellent.
I've never been to Japan, but you know, I'm a huge fan of Studio Ghibli. Some people say Ghibli, some people say Ghibli. But yeah, I'm a huge fan of, you know, Studio Ghibli.
Okay.
There's a Ghibli museum there in Japan, so I'm just like, I definitely want to go.
Interesting. Okay.
Yeah.
All right, next one. Next fan question. Let's keep it moving. From Jessrel Aquino 31, what's the task that you won't forget in the PBB house?
Okay, sorry. Whoa. So
taking
this
it
one
back.
Task where we were assigned to have a partner from the people from the adult edition. So of course there was teen edition, then there was adult. Like how it's like below. It's like hello. Mm-hmm. Okay. Basically, after the partnering, we had to go on boats that had holes in them. And for 5 to 6 hours straight, we had to stay there in the same position. I had to pee really badly. And then we had to help get the water out of the boat so it doesn't sink. So that's what happened. For 5 to 6 hours, that was the moment where I was just like, what am I even doing here?
That's crazy.
Yeah, I had a lot of reflection in that time. You know, I was just like this the whole time. And I'm just like, do I really want this? Am I down for this? Like, I'm like 13 and this is what I'm doing. I think I'd rather study. there's no regrets. I quite enjoyed my time. It's just that task was very much unforgettable.
Wow. That's crazy.
Yeah, never again, please.
Never again. Never again. All right, next fan question.
Okay.
Luna.Garcia, a fan account. If the average human lifespan was just 25 years, how would you live life differently? Interesting.
I'd live it the same way I am now.
I love that answer.
Because tomorrow isn't really promised. So it's like, you just gotta... of course, stick with your values as well as doing the things that you've always wanted to do in your life. So, as long as you don't step on anyone's shoes.
Right. You know what? I love your answers. I'm just going to be like super honest right now. I love your answers.
Thank
all of them.
You.
Awesome. Next one. Next fan question. Pons girl, Ilona, who or what was your inspiration in the song you're currently writing or the last song that you wrote? So I guess it's either one you're writing right now or the last one you wrote that I'm going to talk about later. So any inspiration?
Okay. Well, the last song that I wrote, it's not about anyone but myself.
Okay. So you are your own inspiration.
Of course.
Of course.
You know? You have to, like, in your inspirations, it can be anyone, but you also have to make sure you include yourself, because if you don't love yourself, who's left you living?
You, right?
Oh, and that too!
Yeah. Oh. All right, I think we have one more fan question.
Okay, let's go.
Danny, not me, but Danny from Walnut, California. I love that you're working for McDonald's and you're proud, and so do I. Thank you for your inspiration. What made you choose this company specifically?
Well, first of all, they're a very successful organization. Even from afar, anyone could tell that McDonald's is McDonald's. <You know? laughs> It's like from afar, you can just see that large M right there. And I'm just like, yep.
That's it.
I'm getting that's the one. So yeah, I just what made me choose it was purely for the fact that they're one of my favorite restaurants. Second, they're a really successful organization that I know that I can learn a lot from. I'm by the way studying business at my college, and I'm really learning a lot, and I'm grateful.
Wow.
So, and plus, I get half price food. What kind of question is that? Nah, it's a valid one. But yeah.
That is a valid one. Let's see. One last one. Sorry, I lied. One more.
Let's go for it. I'm like down to even answer like 10 more.
Okay. At Mixed Global is asking. Oh, come on, guys.
Wait, is it your birthday today?
It is, but I was trying to like hide it from everyone. Now they put me on blast. Thank you, guys.
Okay, everyone has to sing it with me. 3, 2, 1. Happy birthday to Danny Boy. Happy birthday to Danny Boy. Happy birthday, happy birthday. Happy birthday to Danny Boy. Now, are you what? Okay.
Wow. Well, you know, I was not expecting that, and people are dropping happy birthdays. Thank you guys so much. That's really nice. And thank you, Ilona, for singing that. That was super like embarrassing for me, but it was cool.
No need to be embarrassed. What?
All right. Let's go back to what we were doing. You had a Kumu like unlock thing recently, right? It was like an unlock Ilona concert. How did that go? How was that? Was it cool? I wasn't able to catch it. So, how was that experience?
It was fun.